What's On Sheron is back, and this time from Sri Lanka, Colombo. It's always an exciting time when I'm at home. But what's more exciting is the fact that I am at NCC grounds. This ground is extremely historic, well, because it was founded in 1888. It has a big, long history, and they hosted first-class cricket in the year 1926. Now, many a legends, local and international, call this place their home. One of them being Farveez Maharoof, whom I'm going to talk to today. I don't need to give him a big long introduction, at least I don't think so. He did play Test and ODIs for Sri Lanka. He also captained the under-19 cricket team in the year 2004, and very recently was called upon to manage the Sri Lankan under-19 squad again. So I'm going to get into all of that and a lot more while talking to Farveez Maharoof. So, before we get on to the nitty-gritties, I'm going to ask you 10 quick-fire questions, okay? So, I want you to answer the first thing that pops into your mind. Okay. Right. So, I've got it all here on my phone because I don't really remember everything. This is a kind of way for me and everyone else to kind of get to know you a little bit better, okay? Hopefully, that's what I'm planning to do. So, beach holidays or ski holidays?
Beach.
Hip-hop and R&B or rock music?
Hip-hop and R&B.
Okay, good choice. Morning person or night person?
Probably night.
Okay. Cats or dogs?
No one.
Really? Nothing at all?
Cats and me. It's definitely a no.
Okay, tea or coffee?
Tea.
Okay. Who do you think has it easier, men or women?
Women.
Okay. Texting or talking?
Texting.
Short hair or long hair on a woman?
Longer.
Okay. This is an interesting one, and I think I've already picked an answer in my mind for you. Mountain climbing or skydiving?
Not both.
Really?
No. You're not scared of heights for sure.
Okay. So let's go back and start from Maharoof as a kid. What were you like in school?
Notorious to start with.
Yeah, you were like it.
Yeah. Yeah, ever since I started at grade one at Vista College, you know, I had a very successful time at the college, especially in sports arena.
Yes.
Studies, academies wise, you know, I was okay. Nothing great, but I got through my O-levels. But mostly I was, you know, putting myself into sports mainly, because I used to play all multiple sports like rugby, football, basketball, cricket and everything. So. You know, my lifespan, my school days was basically just attending practices and playing matches.
Yeah.
So that was how it's like. I mean, and anyone, I'm pretty sure you would agree with me, if you could go back to school life.
Oh, yeah.
That's something that, you know, I would love to do it.
Yeah.
But, you know, all in all, we move on with life. So, you know, the 13 years spent at college was well spent.
Yeah.
And here am I now, you know, have I owned my own kids going to school now.
Yeah. You did say you played a lot of sports in school, but at what point did you decide that you wanted to further your career in cricket?
I mean, when I was 11 years, when I was grade 6, I used to play everything. So one day, principal and prefect of games got together and said that they want me to concentrate only on purely on cricket.
Okay.
I mean, I was a good football player too,
right?
But I was just playing rugby and basketball for passion.
Yeah.
But they wanted me to stop everything, but just to put my 100% to cricket. So I, you know, at that time, the principal and prefect of games, I respect them a lot because they supported me a lot when I started playing when I was 9 years old.
Yeah.
So ever since then, I just thought, all right, this may be the call that I've been waiting for. Someone firm telling me. Even my dad was telling me, so you're doing too much. You know, you're draining yourself, and you know, just putting everything out there in sports. But just pick one.
Right.
But I mean, I always had cricket was my number one.
Yeah.
But love for sports just, you know, got me to doing other sports as well. So, you know, when I realized I didn't realize, to be honest, I was told.
Yeah.
But then I realized after about a year, maybe I definitely did the right call.
Did you, at such a young age, dream of playing for Sri Lanka? I mean, you did captain the under-19 cricket team.
But to be honest, you know, gradually when I started playing well for my college team, ever since when I started playing for under-13s, I definitely had an idea, like passion to or a goal to play for the national team one day. But I never never thought I would do it soon after college life, because I was lucky enough to get into the national team as soon as I left college.
Yeah.
I was just a teenager then. So as I said, I mean, from under 13s, 15s, 17s, 19s, and I had a very good career at Wesley College, capturing all the age group, as well as doing really, really well, and eventually winning the schoolboy cricket of the year All Ireland in 2003. So that was my highlight, definitely in school life, especially, and that gave me a lot of confidence going forward. You know, only big names and those players who have won the most the promising schoolboy cricket of the year have all gone and to play for the national team.
Right.
So that gave me confidence and that positiveness to I can go all the way. But as I said, lucky enough, within a year I was called up for the national team for the tour of Zimbabwe. So it's one of those things that as a youngster you dream of, and suddenly without knowing that you have achieved it.
You have toured the world, and there is nothing more fun than a group of guys or a group of girls on tour or on holiday. I do know there are loads of memories, and I'm sure that the team itself got up to a lot of things. And I'm aiming at something, and hopefully you'll give me what I'm looking for. Can you tell me an unforgettable incident while you were on tour?
Say it in the spot now. I mean, cricket-wise, I mean, you take, you win or lose, you take it away, it comes. Yeah. Losing a game, it definitely hurts. It takes some time to recover, but when you win, you celebrate. That's what you do, because you need to do it. You know? And there have been some instances which will be hard to share some of the things.
Oh, come on.
But overall, as you said, I mean, lucky enough to travel most of the countries, cricket-playing countries, as well as few other countries on visits and holidays and stuff. But unforgettable memories. Cricketing wise, there are so many. I'll tell one story which happened in a cricketing perspective. When I took the hat-trick in 2012 in the Asia Cup in Dambulla, the hat-trick ball, that means after taking two wickets, the third ball, and there was another batsman. And at that time, Mahila Jayawardhan, he wasn't feeling in the slips. And he came up to me and spoke to me, and he asked me, "What are you going to bowl?" And I said, "I'm going to bowl a Yorker, because there's a there was a tail ender batting." And he goes, the tail end was a fast bowler too.
Okay.
So Mahila was like, he will be expecting that.
Okay.
So just think about it. Just think about it. What I'm trying to tell you, so it's up to you. So on top of my mark, I was thinking, right, I'm a person like Mahila says,
yeah,
it, you listen,
because
I have a lot of respect towards him.
Yeah.
And I was like, all right, I'll take his word. And eventually I bowled a length ball, whereas a tail end would have expected a Yorker, as I initially wanted to. And I've just bowled a length ball, hitting those, as you call it, the hard length in cricket. And luckily there was an edge, and the hat trick was on. So that definitely clicked me, because I want to do something, but some senior men came and told me, think about it. He gave me the decision, but he just gave me his opinion. But those are things that you will never forget, especially a hat trick in cricket. Something special.
Oh, God, yes.
And it came in this circumstance, where a legend of Sri Lankan cricket, which I have a lot of respect towards, coming from him itself, makes me really happy.
You were talking about the hat trick, and obviously that was an extremely proud moment for you. And when you do achieve things like that, your parents are proud of you, your family is proud, your friends are proud. But have you ever woken up yourself and thought, wow, I've really achieved something extremely special? Like, have you been proud of yourself?
I mean, I'm proud of myself, what I've achieved, too. I mean, if I'm really honest to you. But I'm a person, I'll take as it comes.
Yeah.
I accept challenges. That's what thrives me in life. I mean, I've been having challenges ever since I started cricket.
Yeah.
Till date, it's been challenges. Life is about challenges. So
right.
I'll take it in a positive way. And as all human goes through, I'll have my off days as well.
Yeah.
But I just fight it through somehow. So have I ever been proud of myself when I woke up? As I said, I'm proud of what I've achieved and what I've given everything. I mean, all my close relatives, my parents, my wife, my kids, I'm very proud of having them close to me, as well as they are proud of me, that I know as well. So I'm being humble as possible. I mean, take it as it comes. That's me. I'm pretty very genuine when it comes to life. So I'll just keep on the way I have been the rest of the life as well.
If you could build a partnership with anyone, locally or internationally, in the cricketing world, who would it be?
I'll probably say internationally. If I say internationally, I would say I would have loved to. My idol was always Glenn McGrath.
Right.
From Australia, yeah. But we never batted together,
okay.
But we bowled together during IPL time. So
okay.
That was definitely the partnership. From my younger days, I never thought I would do it.
Yeah.
But with the IPL coming in, I had the chance of doing it with it in the IPL. So that clicks that box when it comes to bowling.
Yeah.
But when it comes to Sri Lanka and the local, I reckon if I could batted with a player like Arvind De Silva. I know he's a bit senior to me, but we never played against each other in club cricket or whatever. But I had the privilege of bowling to him in nets during training. When he was playing in the national team, I was just a kid.
Yeah.
So I always loved him. I loved watching him bat.
Yeah.
But there are so many other players. Yeah. For me, I have batted with Kumar, Mahela, Sanath, Mao, and all these big players when it comes to batting. But one player I always admired, love to watch, especially when he's batting, is Arvind. So, one day, I know it's too late now, but that would have made my resume full.
So I'm going to take you a little further from the cricketing and your career. What's your favorite artist or band? Who would you want to see?
Ed Sheeran, definitely.
Oh, yes.
And my all-time favorite would be Backstreet Boys.
Okay.
And I've never seen them live, so one day, hopefully, that'll be definitely another box ticked.
Okay.
So those two are my all-time.
If I tell you something, you're really gonna hate me. I've seen Ed Sheeran and the Backstreet Boys live.
I hate you more now.
Backstreet Boys, I was lucky enough to actually meet them. I had a meet and greet with the Backstreet Boys. It was the best day of my life.
Yeah, childhood definitely. When I was growing up, watching them was just unbelievable.
Yeah, exactly. As a dad, you're a dad, you've got two kids. Do you think you're cool?
I am, extremely. My wife keeps saying it.
That's what I was just going to say. Will your wife say you're a cool dad, or will she be?
She does it because most of the time the hard work, as a very busy person, I hardly at home, but she does all the hard work. So my role would be to play the safe role.
Okay.
It should keep everyone happy. So whatever the kids ask, I won't say no.
Okay.
So sometimes when the wife says no, don't do it, sometimes I do it.
Oh, you say.
And I'll be the best dad for the kids, the bad husband of the wife.
Yeah.
But that's how any dad would go through, especially a life like mine. I'm hardly at home most of the time being out. So cool dad, definitely yes.
Yeah.
And being a dad, you just have to plays that it comes. Nowadays the kids are very advanced.
Oh, they
so
are.
You've got to be sometimes some of the answers, the questions they ask, you got to think twice what to answer. So it's nice to be a parent. I'm loving it all, to be honest.
Do you ever kind of push them in a certain direction as you were when you were in school, in terms of like cricket or another career that you would like them to exceed in? Or
One thing I didn't follow that much was studies in college life. Luckily it paid out when I started playing professionally. I did play for a long time and I built my life around it. So I think going forward with the world going the way the world is going, I think studies is a must.
Yeah.
So I keep telling my wife and to push them for studies. Sports will come because I know it's in their blood, the kids' blood. They'll definitely do something, but academics should be number one, and sports will definitely look after itself. I know that my daughter is 8 years old, she's a good swimmer now.
Okay.
She's a good swimmer at 8 years old, and my son is just 5,
right.
And he started playing football and cricket as well. So
okay.
That's in the blood, it'll come through.
Yeah.
But they need that basic academic life to start with, and eventually build a life from there. And if sports takes it over, it's a bonus, but I think every parent should definitely get their children to get the academics number one priority.
What I forgot to do at the start was actually congratulate you because you've been chosen as the manager for the under-19 Sri Lanka team. Yep. And I know you have been involved with them now for a little while. Tell me how it's going and what you are up to and what to look forward to for the team.
I think I was appointed early April to be the under-19 manager for the upcoming Pakistan series.
Right.
So unfortunately, after the terror attacks, the East attack, the tour got postponed. And now we can happily say that on the 26th of May is going to be the first one day in Hambantota. So they are going to come down to Sri Lanka on the 23rd for 5 one-days. And the series will be finished by 5th of June.
Okay.
So really thankful for the Pakistan Cricket Board to trusting our administration, SLC, the security forces to send their team to Sri Lanka and to compete with our boys who have trained really hard for the last 3-4 months. They need some sort of a recognition when it comes to big games like this.
Yeah.
So I can clearly say that last 2 months I've been working with them. I've seen how much effort they are putting in training. So rightly so, they're getting this break to play against probably one of the strongest under-19 teams in the world, which is Pakistan.
And what can we expect to see in terms of the team?
I think we have a decent team. We have some senior players who have been playing under-19 cricket for a while now. And there's some youngsters coming in as well. So it's a good mix of all-rounders and batsmen and bowlers in the team. And led by a very good captain and a player called Nipun Dhananjay from Joseph Vaz, Vennapur. He's a good leader.
Yeah.
And we have a very good management team as well. We got Hashan Tilaratna as the head coach, Upul Chandran as the fielding coach, Chaminda Vaz. He won't be part of this tour because he's going to South Africa with the emerging team.
Yeah.
But after the emerging team comes back, he's going to join us as the under-19 as the bowling coach, and myself as the manager, and the 4 experienced guys as the physios and the trainers and stuff.
You can't go wrong.
No, I mean it's a very good. We're working as a unit. We're working towards a plan. So everything is going really well. Training has been fantastic. So it's just a matter of our boys going out there and showcasing their talent.
Brilliant, Maharoof. I couldn't thank you enough for being here. Really,
pleasure.
You took time out of your holiday today to do this with me. So thank you so much.
Pleasure, Sharon. Pleasure is all mine.